Welcome back. What we're doing today is we're going to be creating a vertical tangent with Civil Accudraw on the profile. So the first thing you're going to want to do is just go to your attach tools and make sure that your existing surface is pulled in. If it's not, it's just, you know, attach reference. Go find your file, coincident world, and attach it in there. Once it's in there, you'll have your terrain border pop up. Make sure that your A001 is in there, of course. And you should be in your CRL file. If you're not, go ahead and switch over to the CRL file and keep following from there. So the first thing you're going to do is you're going to click on this. And when you pull away and hover over it again, your icon should look more like this. Set as active terrain model. So what you'll do is you'll click on that, and what that does is it creates a 3D model inside the 2D program for you to use. If you didn't do that, you just have, if you opened up the 2D 3D view plan, you would just have a 2D line being drawn through without a terrain going behind it. So now what you're going to do is you're going to click on your CRL. Again, pull away, come back. Once you're there, go to Open Profile Model. Now, I know in the manual it says to open up on 2. You can also do it on 4. When I started using Open Roads, Bentley said to use 4 because it was the only one that was kind of set up in this horizontal pattern. So I'm just used to using 4. But 2 also works. Once you get to this point, all we're going to do is come back up here to our feature definition toolbar, set it to alignment, roadway, and proposed. Make sure you've got that turned on and chain commands turned on. Once you've got those both on, you can go ahead and go to Open Roads Modeling. So this box up here, go to geometry, go to profile, and this time you want to go make sure you turn on your Civil Accudraw 2 at this point. So toggle it on. Remember, if these boxes show up, it's turned on and it's not broken. If it's not there, then it is messed up still. And then you'll have to restart the program. But if you've got it shown up, then you're good to go. Keep following along. Once you're here, go to General Tools. Again, just toggle on that Civil Accudraw, or if you've got the button, make sure you turn it on. Make sure that the Z mode is selected. Now you'll go to Geometry, Vertical Lines, Lines, and then Profile Between Points. Profile Line Between Points, sorry. And then what you'll do once you get to this point is you'll key in the start, which is 13200, tab, which locks it in. And then you'll go to your elevation, which is 576.75. And you'll see on this line here how it's locked in. Once I hit tab on this, after I retype in 576.75 and hit tab, you'll notice it locks it right there. And then all I've got to do from this point is left click to create the start point of my line. Okay, and now I'll go to 142.50, enter. See, it locks it in there now, but it still can go up and down. Then my Z will be 583, enter, and it'll lock it in at that point. Just left click again. Next one will be 156.65 at 538, which will then lock it down here. Left click again. And from this point, you'll just follow your open roads, basic open roads project information to finish drawing out the rest of this profile. Once you're done, I will see you in the next video.